Let's talk about stocks in news, and Gruh Finance witnessed its slowest growth, loan growth in nearly 30 quarters in the July to September period. Does this indicate some weakness in growth in the quarters ahead, or is this the conscious decision from the management to slow down growth in these slightly uncertain times? Let's ask the management themselves. The managing director, Sudhin Choksey, joins us right now on the phone line to talk about the quarter gone by. Mr. Choksey, good morning. Thanks so much for joining in.
Good morning.
Is this slightly slower growth a sign of what the management believe the space is looking like currently?
Our first quarter growth was on a weaker side. But if you look at the last quarter, the quarter on quarter, I think we had quite a decent growth of almost 23% over the quarter one. So I think when we look at both the quarters combined together, the overall disbursement growth looks 10%. And I think in the present scenario where the interest rates have been rising on a home loan and real estate sector continues to be in a difficult phase during its fifth year period, I think I would say that this is quite a satisfactory, the momentum.
Yeah. So looking, which is what I was trying to get a sense from you, sir, that do you reckon that looking at the way the space is right now, this could be the order of the day until you yourself believe that things are turning for the better and you would go out and press the foot on the pedal?
Sure. I think, obviously, if there are opportunities in the market, we would look at it. Especially in our segment, where we are looking at a property cost less than 15 to 25 lakhs, I think the supply situation also would be a major factor.
So, I mean, all conversations, Mr. Choksey, that we've had with real estate experts seem to suggest that the problem, if at all, is largely in the luxury end segment. The small and medium-sized ticket houses would probably still find takers. What is your thought on this one, sir?
No, I think that is what, if you go by the rational or the logic, looking at the demand shortage, which government has given, and the kind of the thrust which government has been giving under the PMAY, obviously there has to be a better demand better momentum there. But if you look at it, the government gave a tax exemption to the developers in the last budget. Now, if any particular developer wants to seize the opportunity of taking that exemption, I think he should be in a position to create a supply probably during the second half of the current financial year, or maybe in the next financial year, depending as to how efficiently he has moved around implementing the project. So I think the situation at a low end of the market should gradually improve over a period of time.
Mr. Choksey, what you're effectively trying to say is that unlike the problem faced by other NBFCs wherein the supply of the products is there, but they might be forced to go slow because of their own liquidity constraints or cost of capital, for you the problem is peculiar. There is a lack of supply of the right units for the market to absorb, and that might result in a slowdown, not just for you, but for the players at large?
I think so, because you look at the interest costs also, because what happens in the income segment of the families where, they are 30 to 40,000 rupees a monthly income, which segment which we cater to, interest rates have been rising and will continue to rise for some more time. So I think the home loan will become expensive for them. So I think that on that count also, there probably might be a little slowdown.
You reckon that there could be a rise in asset quality issues, if at all, for the space at large, if not for Gruh itself?
It doesn't appear so far, any worrisome situation on the quality of the assets.
Okay. And in light of what you just spoke to us, Mr. Choksey, would you believe that disbursement growth at this 15, 17, 18-odd% or NII growth at about 10-odd% could continue for the next couple of quarters at least? Or could there be a risk of some slowdown there?
No, I think your assessment is pretty, close to, those figures. And I think loan asset growth today, it is at 17%. Even if the, scenario has to compel it to slow down, probably it might go down to 15% or so. And NIM growth also probably will decline, from what it is.
My final question, Mr. Choksey, as I read from one of the reports that has come out, you've increased your cash levels quite substantially to what you usually used to keep. I believe you've tightened the credit appraisal norms and increased the caution in funding under construction houses as well. When do you reckon that all of these would change as a result of easing of liquidity for the NBFC space at large, or would there be other factors that would make you change these norms slightly?
I think the present scenario, what is prevalent in the financial sector, you know, where the fear and the concerns or the anxieties are very high as regards the liquidity is concerned. Obviously, to manage this risk, we, you know, build up the bank deposits to an almost 7 or 8% of our total borrowings. And obviously, we had to also look at, you know, due diligence intensified, because a lot of, the loans are from the other lenders moving into the market through the agents and things like that. So we wanted to make sure that the quality of assets do not get, affected adversely.
You reckon these cautionary measures would last for the next couple of quarters at least?
Certainly.
Could be longer as well, sir?
Depends. As I told you, I think, you know, let's see what is the pace of the, you know, or velocity of the money which is moving in and out, from the different players into the market. I think it will depend on that.
Okay. My final question, Mr. Choksey, you're a man who has seen many such cycles, not just in the housing finance space, but in NBFC space at large. Do you reckon that the situation is dire, or do you believe the situation will ease itself in the next couple of quarters?
I think it should ease, because I think when you look at 2008, I think it was much worse than this. And I think this is probably will ease in the course of time. And I think the government and the RBI both are fully tracking it. Our regulator every week or every month takes an update as to what is the situation. So I think policymakers have kept an eye on the situation, and I think they will do whatever is required to be done, and they have done so far.
Sure. No, but the policy notwithstanding, I was speaking to one of your peers, Mr. Choksey, and he was saying that people have short memories. This is nowhere close to 2013, because the scenario in 2013 was completely different. So there's no credit freeze. There's only a temporary mismatch. Would you concur?
Yes, I think so. But 2008 was probably, in my experience, was much, much worse.
Okay, then 2013 as well. Okay. Fair call. Mr. Choksey, we'll leave it at that. Thank you so much for taking the time out and joining us this early morning.